And to this evening's meeting, the theme is for the wise man. Every day is a festival. Today is 1st of November, and then we celebrate a lot of things. We celebrate the high school prize. But think of the bright side. Okay, it's actually a challenge for us to remind ourselves how we can do things more efficient, more effective. Consider this. If let's say we only have 2 hours this evening, but we can have more quality, higher quality speech, and higher turnout, and higher learning. Isn't that wonderful, given that same amount of time? But we can achieve and we learn more. So, this evening, I hope that everyone will celebrate together our meeting number 46. And with that, I would like to pass the floor to Ricky Su to conduct the next session, which is the invocation session. To you, advanced communicators, Silver Bronze, and competent leader, Ricky Su.
Fellow Toastmasters, my friends, please take a look at this.
Yes, I was once useless, but now I become more useful. Please, let me live. Use me.
Now, does it sound familiar? Maybe not. We have not heard of that. This was my CC4 number speech 1.5 years ago. At that time, when I presented this speech, I remember my evaluator told me, "Ricky, you are such a potential storyteller." As a new member, I was very happy after listening to this. So earlier this year, I used the same speech for international speech contest. And somehow, I won the club contest. Now, I was not just happy, I was getting proud. Then, I went to the area contest and finished the second, but I still managed to go to the division. This time, I was not just proud, I was arrogant. To prepare for the division contest, I practiced the speech in a club. After that speech, a member yelled to me, "Ricky, no feeling, no emotions, you should go for a drama class." I was dumbfounded. I was offended. I thought to myself, I'm an ACB, but you are not even a CC. I'm a division level contestant, but you didn't even get past your club level. Who are you trying to criticize me? Later, in the contest, my speech was indeed not dramatic enough, and I lost. Ladies, gentlemen, have you also been criticized before? Of course, yes. We are here to evaluate one another. Toastmasters members are genuine. They give you feedback. They want you to improve. But sometimes, some people might not be tactful enough to put our feedback in a nice manner. But it's okay. We are all here to learn. Just don't take it personally. We will all improve together. Yet, there are people outside who criticize for the sake of criticism. They just want to bully you. They want to put you down. They just want to show themselves better than you. But critics are a fact of life. They are everywhere in our life. Now, instead of getting agitated by all these critics, why don't we make good use of them for who they are? Because regardless whether they have good or not so good intention,
they are the ones who remind us we are not yet perfect. Critics are the ones who keep us humble, keep us on our toes. Critics are the ones who show us the biggest room in the world is a room for improvement. So instead of showing hostility to my critic, I could choose to show him gratitude. Instead of seeing our critics as critics negatively, we could choose to see them as people bringing us to a greater height. We can choose to be bitter, or we can choose to be better. It's all in our choice. It's all in our